Hi, I'm George, and we're back talking about production calendars. How can you reconcile a busy, active-looking production calendar with all the things you can do in it and a really clean, specific presentation piece? Come take a look. Now, as you see here, we're already in our production calendar, and we're going to go up to the upper right here to filter events. Click it. And there you can see we have the entire event toolbar opened up immediately. And now I'm going to show you what you can do within this toolbar. So the first thing you can do is you can actually, in this search field, enter an event name. And let's just say we're going to enter shoot. And see, immediately, just by entering shoot, filtering is on, which is an important indicator. We have lock shooting script, and we have shooting. But say you don't want to filter that way, clear the field, and you can go down here, and why don't we filter by an individual? So anybody who has any tasks assigned to them, a teammate of yours, you can filter your events that way. So by assigning teammates to tasks, you're also creating a great way that you can use your filter. Now, something I would definitely use this for is I would make sure that if I had a meeting with, say, the art department, I would just open it up and say, here, let's just look at your task right now. That's a really cool function that you probably don't have on any other calendar you've ever used. So let's just sort these events and filter them by color. If I only want to see the events that are in this color, I can do that. Down here, we have other ways you can filter. Incomplete tasks is a great way to take a look at your calendar and say, this is what we have pending. These are things we still need to do. Incomplete tasks due today, overdue tasks, events without tasks. And then really starting today, within a week, those types of things can become really functional. And when things end as well. So as you can see, there's a lot of different ways that you can filter your events and use filters to show whatever data you really need to find or really need to demonstrate for someone for whatever reason. It's a great way to control the look of the calendar and keep it organized for whatever purposes you may have. So there you go. That's using filters on your production calendar. Next time, we're gonna go over sharing. That'll be the end of our production calendar series. Hope you found this video helpful. If there are any other videos like this you want to see, leave a comment below and check back soon for our final pro tip in this series and more pro tips in the future. Thanks so much.